Welcome to Urban Roll News. My name is Mariam. Make sure you subscribe to Urban Roll on YouTube, Twitter, everywhere, all the social media handles. It's Urban Roll everywhere. YouTube channel, make sure you click on the notification button to get notified anytime we post. We give you the best and freshest entertainment news on your favorite celebrities, interesting and amazing rumors in Ghana happening right here on Urban Roll News. Make sure you support it. Our first story, Ghanaian movie producer Olam Michaels has stated that Kofi Adjorlolo was drunk when he made the comments that some producers in Ghana were owing him money. On an interview on Hit FM, he stated that he was angry when he saw the interview of Kofi Adjorlolo saying that some producers were owing him and all of that. Now, apparently, he has worked with him and Kofi Adjorlolo charged him 6,000 cedis for the movie that he played a role in, and he paid him. Then there was some balance that was left. And he said after the interview, he actually gave him 1,000 cedis as balance. But he said that the actor did not complete the job that they agreed on. The producer claims that although he paid 10,000 cedis as balance to Kofi Adjorlolo, Kofi Adjorlolo did not complete the project that they were supposed to do. Apparently, after the movie, he was supposed to help them to publicize the movie, which he did not. But although he saw the interview, he said the interview made him give him the balance. But he thinks that he shouldn't even have, because the man did not finish his job, but he gave him the money anyway. And he also claimed that he was drunk while in an interview when he actually claimed that people were owing him. And they called Ibrahim Ben Bako, the presenter that actually interviewed the actor during that particular program. And he was asked if indeed the actor was drunk, and he said he doesn't know whether it came from his mouth or anywhere, but he could smell alcohol. He was probably drunk, maybe a little drunk. Moving on to our next story, Sister Derby has expressed her disappointment at medical for the way he behaved during the Sotium concert. She said that although he invited her to come and perform, when she got there, he acted like he didn't actually invite her to come, because she said during the performance, she didn't really enjoy it. She was asked if on a scale of 100, from 10 to 100, how much she enjoyed it. And she said it was a 70. And she said the 30% was actually because medical was, his mannerism was as if he didn't want her there, although he invited her. So that was her problem. She just said she was very disappointed in that. Moving on to the next news, Gyedu-Blay Ambolley has requested for a week to do his investigations and then find out about the proof that he said he had, which made him made some comment that Shatta Kwame has borrowed 50,000 cedis from Musica. Now, Shatta Kwame asked him to apologize or retract his statement within 3 days. Now, he said he needs a week to make his investigations and then come back to apologize or stand by. Gyedu-Blay Ambolley has stated that he needs a week and that 72 hours ultimatum is too short for him. This came after he made a statement accusing Shatta Kwame of borrowing 50,000 cedis from Abuor. And Shatta Kwame also came out to say that it was a lie. And then he and his lawyer actually posted a long document asking him to retract his statement or apologize, or else he'll be sued in court. And now he is saying that he needs about a week to gather his evidences to actually prove that what he said was true. And if it's not true, he would publicly apologize. In a long Instagram post, she said, "It is a shame that it must come to this, that a person my husband calls uncle, mentor, Gyedu-Blay Ambolley, a person old enough to be his father, can perpetrate lies about his reputation and character. Current case in question being his interview at TV3 stating that he has proof that my husband received 50,000 from Abuor as a loan from the Creative Art Fund of 2 million Ghana cedis, which he did not pay back. Aside from the fact that this statement is a total fabrication and untrue, I am in utter shock that a person old enough to be my husband's father, who should know better, can maliciously lie confidently about something that has never happened. Now, the truth, Shatta Kwame has never taken 50,000 from Abuor, never taken 50,000 from Musica, never taken 50,000 from Musica and Abuor during his time as president. He has never taken 50,000 from any agency, institution, business, or company that is associated with Musica and Abuor and has never taken any amount from any institution that is associated with Musica directly or indirectly. Whoever cares to know must note that for the whole 1 year or so that he worked at Musica, the net total of all the monies he was given for driving to meetings, sharing his experiences, and late nights brainstorming was less than 3,000 cedis. This is because the chartered accountant that the Musica administration had hired would not work unless she was paid 400 cedis more to what she was already getting. My husband and uncle Rex Omar forfeited their 200 cedis each a month that they would have gotten as stipend so that the accountant could be paid professionally. My husband paid the Ghana cedis equivalent of $5,000 as tuition for his master's degree in marketing strategy at the University of Ghana Business School to acquire the knowledge he shared with the Musica out of love for the union during his time of work at Musica. It is a chronic addiction in this country that some people spew black clouds to exhaust without proof, calling it my truth. This is not my truth. This is our truth. It is the truth.
Moving on to our next news, Yaponu actually revealed in an interview with Abeku Santana that his song Praises, he had wanted to feature Archbishop Duncan Williams on that song. Apparently, there was a part in the song where the video where they showed a sermon of him preaching to his congregation, and then later they thought about it that they had to write to his team so that they would be aware that this is what he wanted to do. But after he sent the letter, they wrote back to him that they were not interested in his initiatives. He said he was very disappointed on that, but he had wanted to feature him, but since they were no longer interested, they had to take it off the music video.
But Wale and Sarkodie have been at beef with each other for about a year or two now. Recently, this beef has actually gone down. We've not heard anything about it for a while now. A few days ago, Shatta Wale rekindled this beef in a series of posts on Twitter, dissing Sarkodie and his fans and all that. Now, apparently, possigee in an interview stated that Sarkodie has featured an artist that is bigger than Jay-Z, which led Shatta Wale to start this whole thing all over again.
Jay-Z. Hey, yes.
Now he has even released a song title Little Tip to Sarkodie, and it's a whole lot. Now so far Sarkodie has not replied to any of Shatta Wale's disses or his post or anything, so it seems Shatta is enjoying this beef all alone.
If you want to get the best entertainment news right now, you have to go to YouTube and type in Urban Roll News. This is where you get the best and freshest entertainment news. This is a new show, so make sure you go and subscribe and then get updates on everything happening in Ghana. My name is Mariam, and catch you next time.